Om Shanti, today is the 156th day of your godly blessing. And before we go ahead, you can click on the link above and find out a method to do yogasans, to be fit, to be healthy, how to sleep, when to sleep, how much to eat, what not to eat, to lose your weight. Everything is mentioned over here in details. Have a look over there. And now let's go ahead with today's blessing. And let's find out what does Baba have to say in today's blessing so that we remain in a combined form. We feel as if God is always with us. Baba means Father, God the Father. So let's understand the method of always finding Him next to us as if He's just walking near us. He's always there. His presence is there. So in today's blessing, Baba says, may you have a combined form and experience Bap Dada. Bap means God the Father. Dada means the elder brother. So eldest brother of all of humanity is the first child of God, that is Adam, or in Sanskrit we call him, or Hindi call him, Brahma. So that is Dada. So they are together, they are combined, because Adam is not God, but Adam is almost equal to God in terms of qualities and values. So that's why Bap and Dada are combined, to be personally in front of you in a corporeal form. That's what we can experience. So let's go to the explanation. Just as Shiv and Shakti. Now, God the Father has been called as Shiv. Shiv has been known as Jyotirlingam. Jyotir means light. Lingam means a symbol. So, God is symbol of light. Christianity says God is light. Islam says Allah e Noor. God is light. Buddhism also puts on the candles and lights and the diyas or the earthen lamps, and they call God as energy or light. We also say that God is a point of light, a white light energy, and His child being the soul. Supreme Soul's child is a soul, is also light. I am also a light, just that I am into birth and death cycle, but God the Father doesn't come into birth and death cycle. Many people are confused that Shiv and Shankar are the same, but God says, I am separate, I am incorporeal, I don't have a corporeal form like you children. You have a body, you come onto this earth plane and you take a body to do your karma, whereas Shankar has also got a body. So how can two beings be same? So God is incorporeal, Shankar is corporeal with a corp. That's why He is not God. He is a divine deity. So God says there's a difference. So just as Shiv and Shakti, Shakti is those souls who are in a female body, are combined in the same way the Father and the Pandavas, and the Pandavas are combined. So God is the Pandav Pati, and we souls who are in male body are Pandavas. Shaktis are those souls who are in a female body. So God says they are also combined. For those who stay in the combined form, if I consider myself as a soul and I say I am a Pandav, not a Kaurav, I am a Pandav, I remember God, I believe in God, I want to take the right or the righteous path. And even a soul in a female body who believes I am a Shiv Shakti, God's Shakti, a God's power. So I want to be with God and not the Kauravs. So God says Bap Dada is in front of them in all relationships, in a corporeal form, if you believe in that. Now, day by day, you will experience Bap Dada coming in front of you more and is holding your hand. The more we get connected to God, we'll have in our dreams, we'll have while walking, a feeling, an elated feeling, as if God is walking with us, God is helping us out, as if there is not just a feeling, but actually you can see with your mind's eye a form, a white light form, of spark of light who's walking along with you, combined, and as a angel, Dada is there with you, Adam is there with you, walking along with you and guiding you to walk on the path of God while you're doing any activity in your life. So God says, now day by day, you will experience Bap Dada coming in front of you more and more and is holding your hand in every way. You will not see Him with your intellect. Right now when we meditate, we think through our intellect. We imagine the form of God through our intellect. God says, but you will experience Him with your eyes over a period of time. The more you get soul conscious, that means the more I become soul conscious, you become soul conscious, the more we can experience God next to us. You will experience Him, but you will simply have to make the lesson of belonging to the one Father and none other. If we are experiencing life and we are loving and enjoying everything by being attached and dependent on things and people, then to experience this light and this form will be very difficult. God says you'll be dependent on other things. You won't experience me. Choice is ours. So then Baba says, Baba says, but you simply have to make the lesson of belonging to the one Father and none other firm. Then, just as a shadow is always around you, in the same way, Bhavdada will not move away. You'll feel as if he's like a shadow with us in every walk of life, as a father, as a brother, as a friend, in every manner he'll be there. So God says, in the same way, Bhavdada will not move away from your eyes. You will constantly experience him to be in front of you. What a beautiful experience will that be. And if you want to experience that, even I'm practicing that, you too can practice that and feel his presence. Sleeping and eating and drinking, everything you experience, and even in your dreams, you can experience God to be waking you up early in the morning to fulfill your task of the day. And so many other experiences are there. So I leave you with this beautiful experience, beautiful blessing. Have a blessed day. Stay safe, stay home. Om Shanti.